morning to everyone, and welcome to the final round of the 2018 SJIM-Albers International Business Plan Competition. Over the last 2 months, students from St. Joseph's Institute of Management, Bangalore, have collaborated in virtual teams with students of the Albers School, Seattle University, to develop business plans that combat fake news. From among the plans submitted, 3 finalist teams were shortlisted by the European jury. And today, to judge the final event, we have 2 esteemed judges. We would like to extend a warm welcome to Mr. Sujit John and Mr. Sameer Krishnamurthy, our final jury panel, who are with us today. Welcome, sir. I'm Vimasha.
And I'm Sadat.
And we will be your hosts for this event. We now request our Dean, Dr. R. Narasimhan, to give the welcome address.
Jury for today, Mr. Sameer and Mr. Sujit John, faculty and staff, members of the press, and dear students. A very warm welcome to the final round of 2018 SJIM-Albers International Business Plan Competition on developing a business idea to combat the proliferation of fake news, co-hosted by St. Joseph's Institute of Management. SJIM has established a collaboration with Albers School at Seattle University, USA. Both our business schools are located in the technological hubs of our respective countries. At the same time, ours are both Jesuit schools, and we seek to inculcate in our students the ability to think critically for the greater good of the society in which they will go on to become managers and entrepreneurs. Today's event is the finale of a series of events. Over the past 2 months, students of SJIM have been collaborating in virtual teams with students from both the Albers School of Business and Law School at Seattle University to develop a financially sustainable and technologically feasible and scalable business idea to combat the proliferation of fake news. The students from 2 different countries have exchanged ideas and collaborated over the internet. The SJIM students have a keen understanding of the complexity of implementing solutions in the developing world, whereas American students have an understanding of the limitations and concerns with scrutiny. Today, together, they have harnessed the 2 countries' technical and social expertise towards solving serious problems. The jury consists of eminent individuals from 4 countries. The entries were shortlisted by a distinguished European panel of judges, including Mr. Pelle Lucan, Policy Specialist, United Nations Development Programme, Denmark. Mr. Manuel Sapienza, Global Policy Specialist, United Nations Development Programme, New York. And Dr. Florian Lubermann, Venture Capitalist, Germany. Of the 18 teams that participated, the European jury shortlisted 3 finalist teams for today's event. Each of these teams will present their ideas to the audience today and field questions from the final jury. We welcome the esteemed members of the final jury present with us today, Mr. Sameer Krishnamurthy, the Editor-in-Chief at MetaFact and Research Director at Global Security Center, and Mr. Sujit John, Business Editor for the Times of India, Bangalore. I wish all the finalist teams the very best in today's competition. Welcome again. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We will now start with the first part of this event, the presentations by the 3 finalist teams. The topic for this event is to develop a business idea to combat the proliferation of fake news. Each idea is expected to be financially sustainable and technologically feasible and scalable. Each team has 10 minutes to present their business plan to the audience. We have Stefan and Frank at the buzzer, who will let the teams know when there are 2 minutes remaining, and then again when the 10 minutes are up. We request the first team consisting of Gokulan N.T., Mohammad Rizwan, Neha Rohira and Preeta Devi from SJIM and Anish Deodhar from Albers to please come forward to present their business plan.
Good morning everyone, we are team 1, we are the founders of Safe Browse. We, the founders of Safe Browse, initially started with the central question, what is the need for an ordinary citizen to spread fake news? Well, the reasons are rich and complex. They want to share within their networks, that is their family and friend circle. They feel that it is something important for their civic duty, something for their nation and social identity, and for their nation building. Moving on to the opportunity, fake news is centered by social media, that is technology. So we understood that we need to come up with a solution that is technology based. There are any number of applications, news sources, news articles and online courses available in the internet, but people don't prefer it because they feel that it's complex, time consuming and sometimes they're costly, they don't feel that that's worth spending for. And that's the reason they don't prefer it. The number of online news readers are increasing these days and hence the demand for our application will go up. Introducing Safe Browse. Safe Browse is a freemium Android and iOS application that will verify online news articles, news sources and WhatsApp forwarded messages. We have a rating scale starting from 0.1 to 5, 1 being not credible at all and 5 being the most credible one. We also give them a breakdown explanation on why a particular article or a particular content was given a particular rating. We, the founders, will manually create a database which will consist of authors from known certified sources and also news websites and also the URLs from certified news websites. The following are the criteria based on which we will be rating a particular article that involves background check of the author, the websites, and talks about fact check, articles, news check, disclaimers and URL. In a layman's term, what people should do is, they should go to Play Store and download Safe Browse. Once they download Safe Browse, whichever article or WhatsApp message, whichever they want to check the rating for, they need to copy and export it to Safe Browse. Safe Browse will get back to them in a form of a pop-up message which will show the rating and the broken down explanation on why the particular rating was given. Here, we want the customers to interpret by themselves. We are not telling any customer that they shouldn't forward a particular message because it is fake. We are just giving them a rating with the help of our data bank and we are conveying that this might not be legitimate. We are not stopping anybody's freedom of speech or anybody's freedom to share information. Because tomorrow, no writers or news websites or news sources can sue us saying that we took away their freedom of speech. We are legally safe in this way. Moving on, why Safe Browse? Safe Browse is available as an application. It is easy to access, it is not time consuming and it is not complex at all. We have two versions of Safe Browse. One is free version and the other one is the premium version. In free version, it is free of cost for the customers but they can rate only 3 articles per day. And the main source of revenue for that will be the advertisements. In premium version, there are no advertisements but the subscribers will have to pay a monthly subscription amount of 140 rupees and they can rate many number of articles. There are no limitations in that. And of course, we are not taking away anybody's freedom of speech as we have mentioned there, and the readers are self-interpreting themselves. Moving on to the business model. Our business model talks about revenue gain. So our revenue gain is through application users and advertisement revenue as I have mentioned before. Moving on to source of funds, that will be explained in detail when we go to the financials by Google. Moving on to go-to-market strategy. Our target market will be the internet users who read news online and social media, social networking sites and many other applications. Our buyers will be businessmen, professors, students and investors. Moving on to value proposition, everyone deserves to know the truth. Our application helps others to know the truth and share the truth. Moving on to the marketing strategy, as we have mentioned, that talks about press release, on-site blogs, college programs, social media, advertisements in FMs and newspapers and billboards. Our channel strategies will be Play Store, customer reference and optimizing search discovery. Moving on to SDP analysis, as I have mentioned segment and target group before, our positioning will be, we will be positioned as a fake news detection, prevention and removal tool which is available at a reasonable cost. Moving on to the management team, under CEO we have four different departments that consist of CFO, CHRO and admin, CMO and CTO. Following are the executives and analysts who will be working under them. Over to Gokul for the financials.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The source of fund for our company will be through cash of founders, which is 6.708 lakhs, summing up to 33.54 lakhs, and the loan amount of 10 lakhs and angel investors' investment of 10 lakhs, total of 53.54 lakhs. And our initial investment through cash would be 51.04 lakhs, and then the fixed asset will be 2.5 lakhs of computers and furnitures, and it will be depreciated through straight line method at 10% per annum, which is a total of 25,000 per annum. And the breakup of initial investments would be as follows: at the head in executives and executives and engineer salaries, and rent and maintenance, employee benefits and other expenses. And coming into the profit and loss of the first year, sales would be one of the major the secondary income for our company. The major income is our other income, which is the advertising revenue. Sales would be purely through the 700 subscriptions, user premium users into 140 into 12, total of 11.76, and other income is advertising revenue, which is 4,200 per day into which is here 4,200 into 30 into 12, and marketing expense of 10 lakhs, which composed of newspaper, billboard, FM, and events. And coming to the rent and maintenance, it will be 22,000 per month into 12, which is 2.64 lakhs, which is given here. So the total income in the first year will be 26.88, and the loss would be 24.41, but the net loss of the first year will be 25.41, considering the loan amount interest of 1 lakh, and the cash at the end of the first year will be 25.88 lakhs. Coming to the second year of profit and loss account, here the sales is 25.2 lakhs, again it's based on the premium users, and other income is of advertising revenue, which is 18 lakhs, and the total income is 43.2. And this year we are facing a loss of 15.01 lakhs, and the cash at the end of this year will be 11,11,600. When coming to the payroll and marketing and rent and maintenance, if there is an increase in 10%, whereas in marketing expenses we are increasing in the cost by 2 lakhs, and the cost of acquiring per customer is 400 rupees in the second year, whereas in first year it is 667 rupees. Moving on to the third year of our profit and loss account, which is the break-even for our company, the total income will be 67.76 lakhs, and then the expenses will be 61.64 lakhs, whereas the net profit will be 3,11,960 rupees. The cash at the end of this year will be 14.48 lakhs, because we are having a net profit of 3 lakhs, and the sales will be 2,200 premium expenses, and then there is increase in payroll by 10%. And the rent also by 10%, but marketing expenses we are fixing it to the 12 lakhs. So there is no increase in the marketing expenses in the third year. And moving on to the balance sheet projected for the 3 years will be these total of fixed assets will be 2,25,000, and then these are the projected balance sheet. This is the projected balance sheet for the 3 years. Over to Preeta.
Moving on to PESD analysis and how PESD have an effect in our business, starting with political factors. Political factors talks about government and how government will have a support in our application, because government have been continuously working to eradicate fake news. Moving on to the economic factors, it talks about inflation and how inflation will have an effect in our salaries, and also it talks about 3 years tax exemption for a startup. Moving on to social factors, it talks about different age groups and how different age groups will start preferring our application and the online news readers who are against fake news. Moving on to technological factors, our application is totally technology based, so it talks about the entire technological factors and how we will maintain it to meet a competitive edge. Moving on to SWOT analysis, as I have mentioned, strengths and opportunities before, starting with weakness. Our weakness will be less awareness and ignorance of people. Moving on to threats, it will be new entrants, app not successful, and other social media creating a similar app. Moving on to timeline of our business, the first year That is, the entire 2018 and early 2019, we will be working on the preliminary works, getting license, creating the database and raising funds. In the year 2019, once we are done with the preliminary work, we will launch the application. As Gopal have mentioned, the first 2 years we make a loss. That is, in the year 2020 and 21 we make a loss, but in the year 2022 we make a profit worth 3 lakhs less. Once we start making profits, we will further develop our app based on our plan and customers' expectation. I would like to end my presentation by saying that one click to download, one click to verify, and one step to eradicate fake news. SafeBrowse will stand along with the citizens and fight against fake news. Fake news, and this is not an application for entertainment purpose, but this is an application for social cause. SafeBrowse, go beyond the headlines. Thank you.
Dear judges, we gently remind you to enter your score for this team on the score sheet now. Please also write down the question you have for team 1 on the page provided for the purpose.
It's not my question, this clarification. Who is rating the items? Who's rating? Excel can copy paste and put on your app and find the rating. But who is rating those articles or WhatsApp messages or whatever? Without understanding that, I don't think I can even ask what the questions that I need to ask.
So basically, we'll be having a data bank of the journalists and the ratings, which will be based on the 7 criteria which we mentioned in our presentation. So how this happens is, for example, let's say someone is getting a news in WhatsApp or in other social media, they will export that particular news into our app, and that will be scanned, and we will get to know who is the author, and we will get to know the URL through which they are sending this particular news, and we will be seeing whether the particular URL is credible or not, and they will be based on those information, they will be rated, and we will be showing the description of why this particular article is being rated in this. For example, let's say 3 out of 5, we will be saying why they have been rated as 3 out of 5, and then it's up to the readers whether to consider it as credible information to share within their network or not.
I would like to add
on
to that. For example, if there's a WhatsApp forward message, and when we copy and export it to SafeBrowse, if we do not find anything in our database saying that there is such a news in any of the credible news sources, then it will tell them that, sorry, this is not available in our database. So we are indirectly telling them it's not available in any of the credible news sources or by any of the authors. So it might be fake. It might not be legitimate.
Thank you,
Team
1. We now request the second team, consisting of Glenn Clementari, Nishma Maria D'Souza, Nikita Ghatikar, Sandhya M. Raya from SJIM, and Crystal Kirame representing Albers, to please come forward to present their business plan.
The year was 2013. The World Economic Forum said that the digital wildfire is going to be one of the biggest drawbacks in today's world. Good morning, one of our present here, our esteemed judges, faculty, our fellow students. 70% of the world said that, you know, fake news has been one of the biggest problems in today's society. There's a lot of chaos, there's a lot of problems that have been increasing and rising, and this is where our company comes in, presenting to you guys, Kokua Kudiana. Today's news, tomorrow's history. The name of our company is derived from a Hawaiian language, which means working together. Before I even continue this presentation, I just want to show you guys a video on what our company is based on.
How do you know that something happens? 2/3 of American adults use social media to get their news these days. Jim Axelrod is here with a fight against the misinformation. There's a lot of misinformation these days. Jim, welcome.
Good morning. Social media has seen a shift from a way to share personal pictures and status updates to one of the main ways people get their news. But the platforms have struggled to keep a lid on incorrect information.
And I want you all to know that we are fighting the fake news. It's fake, phony, fake.
Never stop believing that fighting for what's right is worth it.
Platform, either updated or authentic news. The mission statement is to help existing organizations to fulfill their missions to deliver authentic information. Well, this is the organization structure. We have our CEOs, CFOs. We have the software team. That's the backbone of our organization. We have a marketing team, a research and development team, and also a news outlet experts. These guys will give us information on what the actual news is, and we will calculate that. Community outreach is one of the major aspects of our company. Educational programs, workshops, and how to eradicate fake news is one of the essential part of our company. Our company is based on an app-based, where customers download the app, and they would place this, they would place any news that they feel is fake in our app. We, using our algorithms and with the help of our technical teams, will detect whether the news is fake or not with an accuracy of 80%. Now, this is not 100%, is because news can come from different, from different aspects. So we need to be sure that we could keep at least an 80% of accuracy. As this, if a news is fake, we would red flag it, we would pin it. And here's where, here's why a customer should get our apps. As much as news that a customer gets, they would be rewarding points. If they get a fake news, they will be given points. And after a certain point, they can redeem their points for rewards from our sponsors or anything, kind or anything. So this helps us to get a huge band of customer base, so that we are trying to build a customer base, so that this is just not about only profits, but about getting the word out that this is our issue today in today's world. Our revenue model is basically that we charge customers on the type and times of service that we provide. It generates revenue from advertisers in exchange for advertisements. It included in educational outreach aspects, as I already told you, and income is generated through kind, through grants, through scholarships, so that we also give internships for youngsters like us, so that we are vibrant youngsters and we like to make a change. So this is a platform for them to make a change, so that we give up what we think is the truth. The next part will be concluded by Sandhya.
Good morning, everyone. So you all will be wondering how our company is different from the other companies who claim to be covering fake news. Well, our company is our company has a reward-based system and incentive which provides which enables us to have a huge customer base. The lack of internet may be a hindrance for the use of our software, but it we make sure that we are making sure that we connect to the masses through offering internships, scholarships, workshops, and even to the educational institutes, which will help us reduce the circulation of fake news. The threat, the major threat for our company will be the dynamic change and the dynamic improvement in the technology. Now coming to the financials, the major portion of our revenue will be the subscriptions. So our subscriptions will be 499 rupees annually. It's a one-time payment, making our total revenue to be $310,000. And our expenses, the major portion of our expenses are concerned with the salary depreciation as well as the other expenses, making our total expenses to be $212,000. And making our net income to be, for initial net income, we hope to make it $98. And we'll break even at the end of the second year. So this is our balance sheet, which the main asset would be the cash and even equipments and plant. So I would conclude our, I would like to conclude by saying that our company's existence is mainly because of the circulation of fake news. Now it's time that we make our conscience make a difference in the world and in our lives and stop circulation of fake news and know what reality is. Let us be a better world and make today's news tomorrow's history. Thank you.
Dear judges, please enter your score and the question you have for team 2 at this time. Thank you. We now request the third team, consisting of Bosco Sylvester, Brendan Carlton, and Neil Jerome from SJIM, Kyle Yu, Keisha Lugito, and Anne Franzio from Albers to please come forward to present their business plan.
Good morning, judges, and one and all gathered here. A scalable and a feasible business idea to combat the proliferation of fake news. We introduce to you MedFi, Media for the Future. So basically, our idea is basically to implement an online media literacy course called MedFi. So it's basically for students, corporates, and individuals who are interested in this media course. It helps individuals to critically analyze and evaluate media in all of its forms. It tells each and everyone what exactly do you go about. So media literacy, this is through an online platform called MedFi. It helps each and every individual to evaluate media in all of its form. It helps each and every individual to know what is credible and what is not. So moving on to the online education in India. Moving on to the online education in India. So we have a lot of tremendous growth in internet users and smartphone users for the past 5 years, and it will be a tremendous growth in the next 5 to 10 years. So as you can see the statistics of universities, colleges, and standalone institutions, we basically, as a business, we have the potential and ability, and if we use the right way to market them, we can easily, you know, kind of influence people and make them aware what exactly media literacy is. So what exactly is MedFoot and what are its features? So apart from providing online media literacy courses, we have live chat to collaborate with experts, we have interactive content, we have plagiarism checks, and we have image authenticity check. And for Indian users, we have Indian vernacular language content, and we have multi-device usage and interactive content. So moving on to the SWOT analysis of the application. So the strengths are basically it's a low cost alternative, it has quality education, quality content, varying packages and vernacular languages. And opportunities, this is a new industry and growing industry, so there's a lot of awareness and motivation that is needed to be indulged to different universities, colleges and schools. There's increased telecom and smartphone penetration, which has a greater potential as a business to grow in India and also take it to different countries. So we have significant youth population and there's an increase in disposable income. See these as opportunities and challenges. We are convincing people because many people are not aware of what exactly this media literacy is. So it will take a lot of time to convince and make them aware of what exactly this media literacy is course all about. And main challenges, we have still poor internet connection in a lot of rural areas. So that is the main issue and that is to be addressed for. And the major threats are big players trying to replicate the content, and we also need to build credibility and through students to retain students and early adopters to use our application. I now hand over the presentation to Neil.
Thank you, Costco. Now I'll be running you through our marketing strategy. So firstly, our marketing strategy would be to spread awareness on the ill effects of fake news and the solution we can provide to it, followed by our features and services that we provide. Now we can take both the emotive and humor route here depending on where we place our content, because even emotions work a lot in India. Like we know, when we touch on the points like agar hamare saath hota, if it happened to us, what will happen? So these kind of things work. Now our target audience, as you can see, are mainly universities and media schools, online education seekers and public and private libraries. Now why universities? Because first of all, it provides us a large customer base. Also, when you invest this kind of money on an idea like faking news, it is very difficult to convince a general audience to do so. But going to the university would really help us. Also, we can approach universities in two ways. First is specific and general purpose. General purposes could be packs for libraries, labs, around 5 to 10 packs. Or specific purpose would be the more convincing one, where we would try to include it as a course, especially for media and law schools, where we will tailor the content according to their requirements, tailor the assessment according to their requirements. So all they need to have is a system and we will do the rest for them. What this ensures us is customer retention, because year on year students would be coming. Also, if students like the course, once they go out, they will tend to be individual users and referrals to others. Also, universities and colleges are averse to change in technology. So if we are the first player in this field, this will also give us an edge in the terms that unless there is some significant change, colleges will not really migrate to another service. Coming to our marketing mix would firstly include events and direct marketing, because when you're targeting universities, you have to go and speak to the top management and convince them with demos, etc., and how it works for them. What we would also be offering is a 5% discount on bulk deals, along with collaboration, like giving them ad space on our website, on our service. Print national dailies, but also educational supplements and magazines, which are followed by both universities and students for ranking and other things. Vernacular press, because we have the option of vernacular language in our service. Online media through your college dunya and other websites, and also discussion forums, admission forums, influences. We have a set of experts who will be guiding us in creating the content and also be a part of this. So they will act as our initial influences, and as we gradually increase in size and scale, we would like to have celebrity endorsements, collaborations with places like Internshallah, etc., and also sponsorship deals. Now expansion. So our idea of expansion is that in the next 5 to 10 years we want to cover all the universities of India if possible, and also mostly to, with the increase in technology, move to tier 2 and tier 3 cities as well. And with the help of our US counterparts, we plan to launch in US by 2022. And also once the university space is saturated, we could move into schools and individual users and place more focus on those as well. Now news is always a perception. So, for example, if you take the Uri attack, the headlines in India versus the headlines in Pakistan will read two different things entirely. So what we are trying to do here, that fake news cannot be really eliminated unless they are hard facts. Therefore, what we are trying to do is create a culture where you can make a more informed decision. So basically, you educate people, help them to analyze and eliminate and make more empowered decisions. Now over to Brendan for the financial.
Thank you, Neil. So coming to the salient features of the packs that are that we're offering. So we have three packs, that being the basic pack, intermediate, and the expert pack. The basic pack starts at rupees 10,000 and there's an increment of 5,000 rupees for each subsequent level. So across all our packages, we have complete, there's exposure to all of our content. This also includes our quizzes, videos, fake news identification exercises, as well as our interesting case studies. We have totally six languages of instruction to choose from. The expert service in the form of our chat and plagiarism check and image checks is applicable only to our intermediate and expert packs. However, there's unlimited access on the expert pack only. Moving on to the financials. So we've gone in for a roughly conservative figure. So the main idea is to start out operations in our first year, restricting it to the four southern states of India. In our second year, we plan to expand all across India. And in the third year, we plan to launch in the US as well as sustain our growth in India. So our total cost in our office setup goes to 30 lakhs in our first year. It's a one-time investment. Our app developer salary is a one-time investment who will also handle our web development. Advertisement is roughly about 40% of our first year's revenue. And the experts will be paid roughly 7 lakhs. So we're trying to maintain a ratio of one expert for 40 subscriptions. And coming to the revenue, so a bulk deal of it will come from our subscription basis. So that's roughly, we'll get 90 lakhs of revenue from that. However, we have only 300 subscribers who will be, who can access the expert advice. We'll 700 subscribers in the first year. We expect it to grow to roughly 5,000 by the end of our third year. Taxes are computable at 18% GST. We will be netting losses in our first 2 years. However, we get profitable in our third year. We have a similar forecast for our market in the US, where we'll again break even in the third year and get a profit of roughly 3 crores in that year. Thank you.
Dear judges, please enter your score and the question you have for team 3 at this time.